Hello everyone, this is Nidarshan 19MD06 and engineering design. So we are going to see about cone surface. Before getting into cone surface, we will see some basic introduction about surface. So surface is an extension of a curve. Surface curve. Curve is a function with only one parameter, whereas a surface is a function with two parameters. So here a surface is generally considered as a skin of an object. So surface model of an object is more complete and less ambiguous representation than its wireframe model. So what is a wireframe model? Wireframe model is a skeletal representation of an object by using only lines and curves. So whereas surface is a complete representation of an object with some output, that is skin that is being covered. It is also richer in its associated geometric contents, which makes it more suitable for engineering and design applications. Surface representation is considered as an extension of curve representation. The non-parametric and parametric forms of curves can be extended to surfaces. So, as I have already told you that the surface is represented by two parameters. So, here it may be represented by two equations, that is non-parametric equations and parametric equations can also be used for surfaces. So, now we'll be seeing the types of surfaces. The surfaces can be classified into two categories, that is analytic surface and synthetic surface. So analytic surface is an extension of a surface using known forms or curves, whereas synthetic surface is an extension of a surface using free forms or free form curves or man-made curves. So here we'll be using in analytic surface, we'll be seeing four different types, that is plane surface, ruled surface, surface of revolution and tabulated cylinder, whereas in synthetic surface, we'll be having Bezier surface, B-spline surface, cone surface, Gordon surface, etc. So we'll be seeing some of the surfaces in next slide. So here, plane surface. This is the simplest form or representation of a surface. So here, the plane surface, to form an infinite plane, we generally require a three non-coincident points to define a plane, infinite plane surface. So this is the simplest form of a surface. Ruled surface. Ruled surface is a linear surface. So we interpolate two boundary curves to form a ruled surface. So generally the boundary curves can be represented are also known as rails. So rails, here in the ruled surface, we do not have any twists or kinks. Next one is surface of revolution. So surface of revolution, we have a curve which is being rotated about the axis of symmetry axis. So to form a surface of revolution, this is an axisymmetric surface. Next one is tabulated cylinder. So in tabulated cylinder, we'll be having a known curve, and the curve will be extended along a certain plane or a certain direction to directrix to form a surface. So here we have a elliptical curve, and that curve is being extended in a certain direction to form a cylinder. And here we have an arc, and the arc to extend it to form a surface. So next one is, these are some of the examples of synthetic surfaces. First one we'll be seeing about Bezier surface. So Bezier surface is a surface which interpolates all the data, most of the data points. So here Bezier curve can be extended to form a Bezier surface. But we already know what is a Bezier curve. So Bezier curve is a curve which only connects the starting and the end points, whereas it doesn't connect the intermediate points, and forms a, and the extension of that curve is called as Bezier surface. So the main difference between the Bezier surface and the ruled surface is that ruled surface, we do not have any twists or kinks, whereas in Bezier surface we will have twists and kinks. So also the Bezier surface is usually represented by using global coordinates, whereas the same Bezier curve is Bezier surface is being extended to B-spline surface. We'll be extending this to local coordinates, local points also. So next one is cone surface. Cone surface is a surface with a closed boundary curve. So where in previously known surfaces, Bezier surface or B-spline surface, it may be open or it may be connecting the data different data points. Whereas in cone surface, it is a closed curve with four boundary curves. Next, we will be seeing a fillet surface. So fillet surface is a is a b-spline surface with two b-spline surface that is being blended, that is called as fillet surface. Next one is offset surface. Offset surface is a known surface which can be redimensioned redimensioned to form a different surface object. So here we have a cylinder, and this the in this here we can offset the direction of the cylinder to form a hollow cylinder as like this. So this is an example of offset surface. So these are some of the synthetic surfaces. Next we'll get into the cone surface. So what is a cone surface? We have already seen that cone surface is a closed form, is a curve that forms closed boundaries. Unlike B0 or B-spline surfaces, this is a closed surface. So cone surface patch is a form of transfinite interpolation, which indicates that the cone surface scheme interpolates to an infinite number of data points. Transfinite interpolation interpolates to infinite number of data points that is being generated, that is to all points of a curve segments to generate the surface. So the cone surface is particularly useful in blending four prescribed intersecting curves which form a closed boundary. So cone surface have four closed boundaries. So here we can see that it consists of four boundary curves, that is along u and v direction. So first image represents the parametric space and the second image represents the Cartesian space. The four curves that are being mentioned here is p of 0 comma v, p of 1 comma v along v direction, and p of u comma 0 and p of u comma 1 along v direction. So the four boundary curves may be treated as p of u comma 0, p of 1 comma v, p of u comma 1 and p of 0 comma u, where u and v ranges from 0 to 1 along the boundaries, and each pair of opposite boundary curves are identically parameterized. So by using these the ruled surface interpolation linearly between two boundary curves in one direction, the equation of the cones patch in v and u direction, that is first curve represent the this is a general ruled surface equation. So it is an analytic equation. So the first equation represents the cones patch in v direction, whereas the second equation represents the cones patch in u direction. So one, you have 1 minus u, and u represents the linear functions. So along v direction we will be representing it as p of u as 1 minus u into p of 0 comma v plus u into p of 1 comma v, whereas in u direction we will be representing p2 of u comma v is equal to 1 minus v into p of u comma 0 plus v into p of u comma 1. So to obtain a bilinearly blended cone surface, we will be adding these two, these p1 of u comma v and p2 of u comma v to obtain the surface, cone surface equation. So even when we add these two, the boundary condition is not being satisfied. So when we substitute v as 0 and 1, so we already know that v and u extends from 0 to 1. So on substituting the boundary condition, that is v as 0 and v as 1, we'll be getting some additional functions like this. So when you substitute p of v as 0, we'll be getting p of u comma 0 as p of u comma 0 plus 1 minus u into p of 0 comma 0 plus u into p of 1 comma 0, whereas when we substitute b as 1, p of u comma 1 is equal to p of u comma 1 plus 1 minus u into p of 0 comma 1 plus u into p of 1 comma 1. So these two are the equations in v direction, that is p1 of u comma v. These are some terms that we need to eliminate to satisfy the boundary condition. So in order to eliminate this equation, we will be using a correcting surface p3 of u comma v. So the extra term can be eliminated by subtracting p3 of u comma v, which is known as correcting surface from the surface equation. This is the equation that is along v direction that is used in the cone surface to eliminate the extra terms. So thus p of u comma v, bilinearly blended cone surface, can be represented in generally represented as p of u comma v as equal to p1 of u comma v plus p2 of u comma v minus p3 of u comma v, where p3 of u comma v is the correcting surface equation. So this can be represented in a matrix form like this. So p of u comma v can be is equal to minus 1 into 1 minus u. So here this 3 cross 3 in this 3 cross 3 matrix, the left column represents p1 of u comma v, whereas the top row represents p2 of u comma v. So here minus 1 1 minus u 1 minus v, and v are the linear blending functions that is used to blend the surface. So here this is the diagrammatic representation of the bilinearly blended Kuhn's patch that we have seen earlier in matrix form. So this is P1 of u comma v, this is the diagrammatic representation of P2 of u comma v. So we have to eliminate, when we add these two, we'll be getting some extra terms. So this is the term that need to be eliminated. So this is P3 of u comma v. So finally we obtain P of u comma v, which is bilinearly blended Kuhn's patch. So we have seen this. The functions 1 minus 1, 1 minus u, u, 1 minus u, u, 1 minus v, and v are called the blending functions because they blend together four separate boundary surfaces to give one surface. So the main drawback of the bilinearly blended Kuhn's patch is that it only provides C0 continuity between adjacent patches even if their boundary curves form a C1 continuity network. So this is the major disadvantage in bilinearly blended Kuhn's patch. So C0 continuity is something that is, it represents, when we consider two patches of common edge, when the two patch has the common boundary, then common curve, then it represents the C0 continuity. Whereas if they represents the common direction of the tangent, then it is called a C0 continuity. In bilinearly blended Kuhn's patch, we do not expect C1 continuity, whereas only C0 continuity is being that is positional continuity. So gradient continuity or C1 continuity over the boundaries of a patches of a composite cone surface is essential for practical applications. So in Kuhn's patch, the gradient continuity is must. So instead of the linear functions that we have seen earlier, that is u, 1 minus u and u and 1 minus v and v, instead of that, we are using f1 of x and f2 of x. So those are called as cubic Hermite polynomials, and those are used instead of the linear polynomials like 1 minus u and u respectively, or bicubically blended Kuhn's surface results. So this patch, the Kuhn's bicubically blended Kuhn's patch may guarantee us C1 continuity. So this is the diagrammatic representation of cross boundary derivative. Here you can see PU of 0, comma v and PU of 1, comma v have different directions. So that is PU represents the PU represents the differentiation of the curve with respect to u, and PV represents the differentiation of a surface with respect to v. So this is bilinearly blended Kuhn's patch. So here the f1 of x function and f2 of x function of the cubic Hermite patch is given. F1 of x represents 2x cube minus 3x square plus 1. F2 of x is equal to minus 2x cube plus 3x square. So instead of using 1 minus u and u, we have to use f1 of x and f2 of x in order to obtain bicubically blended Kuhn's patch. So similar to the bilinear patch, the matrix equation of the bicubic Kuhn's patch can be written as minus 1 f1 of u, f2 of u, and this is the general function, and minus 1 f1 of v and f2 of v. So this is the representation of the bicubic Kuhn's patch. So in order to check the continuity across the patch boundaries, so we need, let us consider patch 1 and patch 2. So let us take this curve. So here you have patch 1 and patch 2. So in order to find the continuity, we need to satisfy these two conditions. That is, P of 0 comma V of patch 2 must be equal to P of 1 comma V of patch 1. So here, this curve represents the P of, this is patch 2, P of 0 comma V of patch 2. This is P of 0 comma V of patch 2, and this is P of 0, 1 comma V of patch 1. So these two, both are equal, and the C1 continuity exists. So this is C0 continuity exists. So in order to kind of satisfy C1 continuity, we need to differentiate the function with respect to u, and then we have to equate the P of 0 comma V of patch 2, that must be equal to P of 1 comma V of patch 1. So C0 continuity is automatically satisfied between the two patches because they share the same boundary curve. So for C1 continuity, we have to differentiate with respect to u, and on differentiating, we will be obtaining G1 we'll be obtaining in differentiating f1 of x and f2 of x with respect to u, we'll be obtaining g1 of x and g2 of x, that is 6x square minus 6x and minus 6x square plus 6x. So when we substitute the boundary equation over here, that is x as 0 and 1, we'll be getting 0 g1 of 0 as 0, g1 of 1 as 0, g2 of 0 as 0, g2 of 1 as 0. So here we have so g1 of 0 and g2 of 0, g1 of 1 and g2 of 1, or everything will be 0, and we'll be obtaining the final equation as p of u comma v is equal to f1 of v into pu of u comma 0 plus f2 of v into pu of u comma 1. So in order to substitute our common boundary curves, that is the common boundary curve is 0 comma v and 1 comma v of 0 comma v of patch 2 and 1 comma v of patch 1. When we substitute the common boundary curves, we will be obtaining f1 of v into pu of 0 comma 0 plus f2 of v of pu of 0 comma 1, and at p of 1 comma v of patch 1 we'll be obtaining f1 of v p of 1 comma 0 plus f2 of v of pu of 1 comma 1. So on substitution we will be finally obtaining that pu of 0 comma 0 and pu of 1 comma 0 are same, and pu of 0 comma 1 and pu of 1 comma 1 are same, so thus making it as c1 continuity. Therefore continuity of cross boundary derivatives is automatically satisfied for bicubic cones patch if the boundary curves of c1 continuous. Next is instead of going for f1 of x and f2 of x, we can be normally a cubic Hermite patch has four equations: f1 of x, f2 of x, f3 of x, and f4 of x. So when we substitute everything, that is a more flexible composite c1 bicubic cone surface can be developed if, together with the boundary curves, the cross boundary derivatives are also used. So p of u comma 0, p of u comma 1, p of 0 comma v, p of 0 comma v, and p of 1 comma v represents the boundary curves, whereas pu of 0 comma v, pu of 1 comma v, pu of u comma 0 and pu of u comma 1 represents the cross boundary derivative. So when we use this also, the more flexible c1 bicubic cone surface can be obtained. So these are the two equations, p1 of u comma v and p2 of u comma v along v and u directions. So of the cubic Hermite interpolants can be defined as f1 of u of p of u 0 comma v, f2 of u of p of 1 comma v, plus f3 of u of pu of 0 comma v, f4 of u of pu of 1 comma v, whereas these last two equations represents the cross boundary derivatives. Next one is p2 of u comma v is equal to f1 of v pu of 0 comma u comma 0 plus f2 of v of p of u comma 1 plus f3 of v of pv of u comma 0 plus f4 of v of p of u comma 1. So where here f1, f2, f3, f4 are defined as are the functions as given below. So next one is, so this can be represented in the matrix form like this. So minus 1 of f1 of u, f2 of u, f3 of u, f4 of u in a row, row matrix, and this is a general form. So here this left column represents the left column represents the fp1 function, whereas top row represents the p2 function, that is this function. This top row represents the function, whereas the 4 cross 4 matrix, this 4 cross 4 matrix, lowest row right 4 cross 4 matrix represents the bicubic tensor product surface. So this equation represents the bicubically blended cone surface. So when we look at this equation, the lowest 4 cross 4 matrix represents the bicubic tensor product surface. So here the bicubically blended cone surface can reproduce bicubic surfaces, that is bicubic surface can be represented by using this equation itself. On the other hand, we cannot represent the bicubic cones patch by cones surface by using bicubic surface. So that is what it's given here. On the other hand, bicubically blended cones patches cannot be described in general by bicubic tensor product surfaces. Hence, for a much richer variety of surfaces can be obtained using bicubically blended cone surface patch. So that's the overview of cone surface. Thank you.